unidentified school district recently held an H1N1 PSA, that's public service announcement, video contest across all grade levels to see what kind of great work could be produced. And we have today on stage behind me the winners of the elementary school level and the high school level. So let's meet them and find out about their work. You are?
Justin.
Hi, Justin. And here is?
Prithvik.
Good to meet you.
Amanda.
Amanda.
Annabelle.
And?
Sarah.
All right, Sarah. And you are all together in which class?
Mr. Neal.
Mr. Neal's class. And you're in which grade?
Fifth
grade. Sounds like an awesome time, huh? Great. So remind me of your name again?
Amanda.
Amanda. You were given this assignment, correct?
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about what you had to do.
We had to figure out what to do first, and then we had to write it, and then produce it.
So it was a multi-step process for the video, and I think the video could be anywhere between 30 or less than 60 seconds or less, and it had some particular things about the H1N1 flu, and you had to talk about preventative measures, correct?
Yes.
And so you as a group worked together to create that video, correct?
Yeah.
Excellent. And what was your how were you involved in this video?
I was one of the writers.
Nice. Was it a hard assignment?
Yes.
Sleepless nights?
No.
Okay. Awesome. Back to Big Justin here in the end. Justin, how were you involved in the video?
I was another writer.
Worked together on this assignment? Nice. Well, we have the video here with us, so let's take a look, and we're going to watch this video.
Swine flu was first found in people in the U.S. in April 2009. At first, the H1N1 virus was called the swine flu because it was similar to influenza viruses that are normally found in pigs in North America. However, studies have shown that this virus is very different, but the name stuck. You can't catch the swine flu from eating pork or pork products that have been properly handled and prepared. There are a few simple things that everyone can do to prevent themselves from catching the H1N1 virus. Vaccination is usually the best way, but washing your hands frequently and covering your coughs and sneezes vampire style can help too. If you do get the swine flu and your symptoms become severe, you should contact your doctor immediately. Make sure to stay home, rest, and drink plenty of fluids until your symptoms have been gone for at least 24 hours.
Hey, that was great, guys. Really impressive. I can see why you guys ended up winning first place for the elementary school level. I guess now you go on to the state championship and then probably on to the world championships then. No? Oh. I'm embarrassed again. Look at me. Over here, our high school entrants, and you are?
Grace.
Hi, Grace.
Cammie.
And Cammie. Grace and Cammie. Now, this assignment, was this something you did outside of class, or was this something that you did as part of a class?
It was part of the class as a grade, so we had to do it.
Had to do it. Yeah. Darn those grades. Was this a video production class?
Yeah.
Okay. And so, what did you think of when you wanted to create this video?
We just did it, like, on top of our heads. We didn't really think about it and stuff.
Nice, just kind of went for it.
Like, yeah.
Whatever happens, happens. And look, you won. Now, I understand, Cammie, that you were the actress in this, correct?
Yes, I was.
Is this your first acting gig?
Yeah, it was.
Is this the beginning of a bright career for you?
Yes.
Academy Awards, like, right around the corner.
Yeah, I'll leave my autograph for everybody.
Will
just
you?
In case. Yeah, just
awesome.
In case.
Thanks. Well, right here, we have that video from the Cerritos High School pair here, and we're going to take a look at it. Thank you. Well, representing the middle school level were a group from Betty Middle School, and they were unable to be here this evening, but they have sent ahead a chance to watch a Slime Boy, the name of their feature. So we're going to take a look at it.
The Adventures of Slime Boy. He looks like a normal 13-year-old. He is friendly and generous. He studies hard to keep his grades up. But he has a dirty little secret that nobody knows about. He doesn't wash his hands. He is Slime Boy! Using the latest in viral vision technology, the germs on Slime Boy's hands now become visible to the naked eye. Unknowingly, he may be passing the H1N1 virus around to his friends and classmates. Little do they know, Slime Boy may be sharing a very serious disease with them. Sharing isn't always a good thing. Wash your hands. Help protect yourself and your friends from the H1N1 flu virus.
All of the videos that were entered for the contest are available at our YouTube channel. So you can go there and take a look at them and vote for the ones that you like best. We're going to have a contest between all of the videos that are available between the elementary level and the middle school level and the high school level. And the one that has the most views will get another separate recognition and prize. Currently, Slime Boy is in the lead. So, you know, those of you who have friends who made other videos, get out there and vote for them. Up next, we have the district nurse, Penny Goforth, who's here to talk to us about the H1N1 flu and ways that we can prevent it.